Okay, so I'd like to show you how to make a hot chocolate then, the perfect winter warmer, and to talk a little bit more about the chemistry and science in general involved within the process. So first of all then, we have a water bath, a bain-marie type style, in order to preserve some of the delicate volatile aroma compounds of the chocolate in particular, which set this only at 45 degrees. So to the beaker then, that's up to temperature, I'm going to add half a pint of whole milk and a stick of cinnamon. So the flavour compounds in the cinnamon aldehyde, will diffuse into the fat globules in the milk and impart its flavour into the hot chocolate. Okay, so to the milk and cinnamon then, we're going to add the chocolate. So dark chocolate in particular, the crystal structure of the cocoa fats and the sugar is engineered to melt just above body temperature, so to literally melt in the mouth. Okay, so we're now going to add the cocoa solids. Cocoa solids are derived from the ground roasted cocoa beans and they contain a lot of starch. So starch is the energy storage molecules in plants whereby sugars are linked together in long branch chains. If I were to add the powder simply to the hot chocolate, those chains take up the water molecules become trapped then between the chains and the branches, causing them to expand and mesh together. What that leads to then is the prevention of water molecules reaching the centre of the lumps, and what you'll end up with is lumps within the drink. So what we're going to do then is to add the cocoa powder to a beaker and then add a small amount of milk in order to make a paste. By making the paste first, it enables the mechanical grinding of the lumps to allow the water molecules to reach the centre and yield a nice smooth hot chocolate product at the end. To our mixture then, we add the thicker paste, which is now free of lumps, and with continued stirring that will work nicely into the hot chocolate. Okay, so to our mixture then, we're adding sugar to taste, so a fair amount in my case. For additional flavor, I'd also like to add vanilla extract. Very aromatic, gives it that sweet, creamy, almost warming flavour. To increase its winter warming properties, I'm also going to add some chilli powder. So capsaicin, the active compound in chilli, binds to receptors in the tongue and fools them into relaying messages to the brain of an experience of a hot sensation. Okay, so I think it's ready, it's time to serve up. There you have it, one chemically perfect winter.